GTV. Today we'll be showing you how to change the contacts on the ABB A-Line A and AF145 to AF175 series of contactors. I will be using the AF145 series for this demonstration since the AF145 uses similar contacts with the others and can be replaced using the same methods. For replacing the contacts, I will need to have a T20 and T25 size torque or star screwdrivers. The screwdrivers will need to have a narrow shaft, unlike the multi-tip screwdriver where the driver bits are interchangeable. These particular screwdrivers tend to have a shaft too large for the opening to the contactor screws. With my T20 or SD20 screwdriver, I can unfasten the screws in the four openings on the front cover. I will only need to turn the screws counterclockwise 90 degrees before they pop up. I can then remove the front cover and place it upside down on the table. The front panel that houses the carrier also contains the movable contacts on the back, as the base houses the arc chutes and fixed contacts. To remove the movable contact, I can push down on the spring located on the carrier and then pull the contact out. I can then put in my new movable contact by again pushing down on the spring and sliding in the contact over a piece of metal. The indentation on the contact should line up with a nib attached to the piece of metal. To remove the fixed contacts, I will use the T25 or SD25 screwdriver. I'll start off by setting the base upright and then take off the arc chutes by hand to reveal the T25 size star screw. With my screwdriver, I will unfasten the screw until the contact falls out. Before assembling my new contact, I will take the star screw I just removed and place it in the hole of my new fixed copper contact. I will then slide the copper plate so that it rests inside the other metal part of the contact. I can then place this into the open slot on the contactor and fasten it using the T25 screwdriver. I will then replace the arc chute and place the other part of the contactor that has the movable contacts on top. I have to make sure that the springs line up with the appropriate openings, or I could risk damaging my contactor. Once in place, I can use the T20 screwdriver to push down on the screws in the front and turn them clockwise 90 degrees so that they latch onto the base of the contactor. After ensuring they are fastened together, I will test my contactor to make sure that it is actuating properly. Replacement kits for the AF and A series of contactors, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at galco.com.